That's ghetto.
Y'all remember that?
No.
Smart Guy?
Smart Guy? I watched every episode of Smart Guy. Smart Guy is funny.
Marcus Mann, when they had to do the video project, that was the song, Girl, You Know I'm Button You.
What? Marcus was killing that shit.
I forgot that fucking
Don't
song.
Don't hate me.
Damn, I might go home and watch that shit now, because that shit funny
Don't
as hell.
Don't hate me.
Oh, I don't want to smell cigarettes.
You complicated.
You complicated. I should just say you're complicated. You're in a complex situation.
This ain't working.
This ain't working.
Push it hard.
Push it this real
so
hard.
Annoying. Sorry.
Come
on, throw it. I'm gonna show you that it works.
Go ahead. Let me see.
I'm gonna show you that it works.
She said rejected.
What the fuck?
Huh? I'm recording.
You got the whole.
Ow! Thing. It works. Right. I just
good amount of it.
Not oh, there's some bullshit. It's not working right now.
No love.
Yeah, I'm gonna. Gotta give it time. Oh shit, that's what it say. Never mind.
Stunning pancake. Don't you want to watch this burger?
Yeah,
and pass
me a
mask. Pass
me a mask. Pass me a mask.
Why? We already recording. She got to blur your face out.
No, you go with
Well, it is stationary. It'd be simple for me to blur your face out. I'm
thinking about shit. I'm about to start talking about shit. Don't get me.
That way.
I'm not thinking about.
You want to put your hood on?
Mm-hmm.
They look
this
good.
Is some bullshit.
It's your shot.
You ready?
What the fuck?
You're about to get smoking too. So it'd be easier for me to just blur your face off.
I'll do this.
Oh my goodness. Yo, what the fuck? That's your face. You know that, right? You took off your nose and your mouth.
It's his character.
It's just a mustache now.
Louise, you know.
Do you see it?
What up? It's your boy Sativa Jones, aka LeBron James, BKA Young Shane Botland, because the older one. He grows more and more complex in
still
my
look
eyes as I grow. You still haven't seen Weeds.
I gotta look him up. It's on Weeds?
It's called Weeds.
The show?
Yeah, the show.
Oh, is it good? Like Sinner?
It's like the beginning of the good shows.
Oh, wow. Okay, go ahead.
CKA Artisan Lupone, we lead. EKA Jimmy Buffett. Because I toast, I blast off, folks. And I'm here with
it's your girl Olivia Wilde, of course.
This is
Wiz. Scam. Move on.
And this is the Sativa Experience. So guys, I told y'all, like, as a late, we're about to start diving into, like, asking life's real questions. I want to know, like, what goes on. We got a dope fiend coming up. We got a prostitute coming up. I can tell you some of the shit that's been in the works. You feel me? I want to talk to all different types of lifestyles and beings. You feel me? Buy a homeless man in the mail. As long as you take a bath first, be good. This is the Sativa Experience. Holla. So, with your profession, how does it... Wait, what kind of scams do you do? Because it's all different types of scams.
I do all of them. I do all type of scams. I do every type of scam.
You want to list them for us?
Credit cards, bank accounts, checks, top of the line fraud. I'm talking about insurance fraud. Whew, the list goes on. I'm so scared.
I'm nervous.
Oh my
it's
God.
Not that I'm nervous. I'm nervous of the police.
We still gonna have to just block your face.
This is my personality. You know what I mean? This is not really true. But I'm just telling
allegedly.
You. Allegedly, you know.
Allegedly.
You know, this is my personality. I'm a scammer. You know what I mean? But, yeah, I do everything. As far as everything. I print it. I emboss it. I swipe it. You know what I mean? It ain't no third parties. What was going on. You know what I mean? I print up checks. Money orders.
Awesome.
You know, I deal with a lot of clients, a lot of people, every day, day-to-day basis, you know what I mean?
So, like, what was one of your best days scamming?
You know, the first day I started scamming, I made $10,000, first day. And see, I was a working guy. I used to work. I didn't always scam. I used to work. So
you didn't always scam.
I used to work, you know what I mean? So I just had a baby. I got laid off from my job. So that's it, put me in a bind. Bills started adding up, you know what I mean? I had to take off anyway because my bed was low. I had a low platform bed, so my baby mom, she couldn't. You know what I mean? Get up like that. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So I had to take care of the baby. But bills was adding up. But I came across, you know, my baby mom, you know what I mean? She came across something and had some credit card numbers on it. So, you know, I was giving them off to somebody in my family. My uncle, he was doing this shit before me. I was giving it to him. But he wasn't cutting me off. Like, I wasn't seeing no real money. I was getting like $40 a card.
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
So at this time, I'm about to get evicted. I started getting finessed. I'm about to get evicted. I got bills on top of bills. My baby mom, like, hold up, we're not giving it to him. We're going to do it ourselves. So I'm like, all right, I slept on it. I woke up. I'm like, look, this is how we're going to do this. So we started making purchases. All credit cards that wasn't ours, getting the shit immediately, and selling it for half of what it was. So I made $10,000 the first day I ever started scamming. First time I ever really put work in on a credit card, I made $10,000. So I said, I'll never stop. I wouldn't stop. Or I'm not working for nobody. I can't. I wanted to stop. I stopped. And shit started pounding on my. I had a loft, then I had a condo. I was living in, what you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. I had a little condo. I had car payments. I had my car payment. I had my baby mom car payment. I had bills on top of bills, and I couldn't stop. I was like, fuck it. I quit work. I quit back the other job. I got back getting into it. So that was it. You know what I mean? But. You can see a lot, you know, people call this white collar crime, you feel me? White people do it, you know, but they doing it to a different level. They going in the suit, they going in the bank with a suit, and they going into somebody else's name, getting $100,000 out their bank account, because they white, they're not questioning it. I'm black, you know, and my people, you know, Spanish or whatever. But we of the minority, you know what I mean? We don't get a pass anymore. So it's more risky for us. But trust me, I get it done. You hear me? But, you know, any questions, any other questions y'all want to ask me? Anything else?
Like,
what's your letter, brother?
All right, what was, like, the scariest situation about, like, swiping the credit card? Cause like, what if they like be like, nah, this shit report is stolen, so hold on, sir.
There's no way that they can actually tell if the car is stolen. People get declined every day. So say if my car don't have the money that's supposed to have up there, alright, either I can try another car or I can walk away. But see, we don't know the laws and if we knew the law, how we knew the law, we'd know in any major consumer company, they're not allowed to touch your credit card. You're not allowed to touch it. You get what I'm saying? some stores that go by the protocol of if you use credit, we have to see your ID. But if you use debit, they don't, because debit allows PIN. So that's another place, that's another verification. You get what I'm saying? But I know the law, and I've been doing it for a while. You know what I mean? So I know the ins and outs. At first, I used to be scared. It depends on what you're going in there with, you know. But I done been chased all through the mall.
Well, that makes sense, because in retail, even if a person just need help swiping their card, we're not supposed to touch their card to swipe it and help them. Like, even if an older lady was sitting there and she wanted you to help, she has to swipe the card.
So when I was working at BJ's, somebody came in with fake credit. He had a few cards, but they told us, you know, if the card declines or whatever, if it's like fishy, ask for the card, you know, and I asked for the card, I asked for his ID, and his name didn't match with the card at all. He was like, oh, that's my middle name, da 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 da. But then when the receipt came out, the numbers on the card didn't match. So that's how he got caught.
Yeah, but you know what? I would have said, you know what, give my card back, you know, I'm gonna get my lawyer. Cause that's against the law.
Okay.
You're not supposed to touch my, you're not supposed to touch my card. But they do that because scammers, you know what I mean? That's they on. This is a different lifestyle. It's hitting this epidemic hard because everybody is doing it.
Everybody's,
you know, at first it was
the spiritual scammers. God damn.
But now.
Everybody's scamming.
Everybody got a different way of scamming. You got insurance fraud. You got motherfuckers that get insurance on the car and crash them, and it be some bullshit cars and get the money off of the insurance or whatever. You know what I mean? Boost your credit up too. You know, it's mad ways you can dispute shit off of your credit. You look, it's. I know about credit consolidation. I looked deep into it. When I first started doing it, I looked to the ins and outs, the goods, the bads, everything around it, because I wanted to know what I was getting myself into. So, you know, it's like right now, my credit score is 736. You know what I mean? I can get a business loan for $250,000. And I'm just in the process of getting my name hooked onto a CPN. CPN is a different type of social. You know what I mean?
A different type of social.
It's a different type of social.
You're a whole new person.
But it's business.
Master disguise.
So you know what I mean? Shit that I do know, it could benefit. You know, people like us, the minority, we. Black Latinos, our family ain't teach us about credit.
Right.
When we was young, they was putting bills in our name to fuck up our credit. You know what I mean? But the white person, the white people, they tell their kids about credit and set them up and make sure that they pay their cell phone bill on time or boost this or get a credit card, a secure credit card, and put this amount of money. Some about utilization.
Let me know what. Not gonna save the image of my dad.
You know what I mean? So, you know, it's about knowledge. It's about knowledge. It's about knowing. It's about knowing some shit. If you know some shit, you get far. That's what I know. A scamming is just reading the fine print. That's it. That's what scamming is. It's just reading the fine print. Reading the print that nobody don't read. Because you ain't know that you can get all your money in one shot from a different state from unemployment.
What?
But I read the fine print. Exactly.
What?
I read the fine print.
What you mean?
See? A lot of that shit, when people was going on vacations, everybody was going on vacations, getting about 10,000 into their child account, doing unemployment. You could pull unemployment in a different state, and they giving you, instead of waiting for stimulus checks or whatever, or waiting for unemployment convenience shit, they give you all your money in one whop. For however long the COVID shit was going, the COVID made it even easier for scammers. I can walk in a place with a mask on. Mm-hmm. I can walk in a place with a mask on. I have to have a mask. I won't get served if I don't got one. So you ID me. What you ID?
Who's true?
Right. It's about thinking, man. That's it. That's it. I just learned. I just, instead of working harder, I just was thinking smarter. And that's it. I will never stop what I do. And I just, you know, I'm a, like I said, I'm a personality.
What's up with all Nick Casanova and all them getting caught up with these PPP loans and shit?
What that shit is about, like, you know what I mean? You got people that's getting. A lot of these celebrities that's in these not even these mansions, these high rise apartments and shit, they getting that off of CPN, man. You know what I mean? A lot of these people that think they live in that lifestyle, that's this what they doing.
Makes you wonder.
This is what they doing.
Am I in the wrong field?
Oh, shit. I'll tell you that. Shit. Don't knock it until you try it. But see, don't try it. And it's about patience. It's hard work. It's hard work doing this. People on your back. They want something, need something. You growing enemies or niggas trying to get you, rob you because they think it is. People trying to get close to you to leech off you. You got a lot of shit that goes on with this. Like, I done been held for ransom. I got real stories about this shit.
Yeah, that's what I was about to say. Like, because, like, at the end of the day, like, outlaw shit is just like a hierarchy, like just toughness and betrayal. We got the stick up boys. They all out brute force. Like, they not gonna try to finesse you nothing. I'm gonna fuck you up, or you gonna give me what I want. Even if you give me what I want, I might still fuck you up to prove to the next nigga he better just give me what I want the first time.
Well, see. With money, you gotta have muscle. You gotta be able to think.
Yeah, that's
what. But I. Don't put us. I don't put myself in no situation where that can happen. You know what I mean? God forbid. You know what I mean? And a motherfucker that want to rob or take something from me, they can't afford to be in the place I'm at. I go to Grand Cafe for breakfast, if that, they can catch me somewhere like that. But they can't even afford to get a plate out there. Might eat Ruth Chris like McDonald's. I don't go, instead of being in Garden State Mall, I might go to Riverside, over there in a Ferragamo store. I do different shit. I keep myself, you know, I'm living like this. I put myself in a part. I can live off somebody else's credit score. Shit. He got a 700 credit score. I want to live like him. He living above me. That's exactly how I'm going to live. Just like this guy. I deserve it. I deserve all this shit.
So with the people on the other side of it, like the people who are getting scammed, how you feel about them? Or how do you approach that side of it?
Everything comes with insurance.
Right.
Everything comes with insurance. The bank got insurance on their money. The credit card lenders got insurance on their money. All they got to do is dispute it. Oh, it's not me. They say it's not them, and they get their money back. They don't get cut. Only people that get fucked up is the insurance people. That's it.
They taking above their necessary means to
anything. Yeah, but they're the insurance company. That's their job. That's what they're there for.
So, you don't want to tell us about when you got held for ransom?
I mean,
because I want to know.
You know, it was, you know,
You don't want to talk about that?
You could talk about running through the mall.
Oh, yeah. You know, I'm going, I got a bunch of credit cards. I got one store card. And this one high, I don't know how much money on here because I can't even check it. But I know it's high because I keep going back in the store and it's going through. So the last time I go through, and this girl is like, you think you're going to go back in that store? You've been in there all week. I'm like, fuck it, I don't care. I need to try this around Christmas. Go in the store, some fat guy, like, blocked the entrance. So I said, oh, wait. So I'm looking. So I'm like, wait, let me put my stuff back. So I start walking out. And they grabbed me up. So I'm like, oh, like, let me get up out of here. So then I got up out of there. I start running. They chasing me. They grab me again. I get up out of there again. Try to run again. They grab me. I'm like, damn, I ain't getting out. So took my ass in. They was like, oh, you can come here for a pass. I was like, no, I should have left it more alone. That was it.
They say when somebody say it to you, that usually that's your sign right there. Yeah,
but I didn't care. It was at times of the mall, I'd go there and spend cash, and there'd be on my so
long.
Yeah,
like, they turned you in?
Yeah, I went to jail. I went to the holding cell, but from the holding cell, I got ROR home. From me spending $5,000, right, and only having to pay $300 in fines, I take that any day. So it was only what I did for $5,000 was only a $347 fine.
Yeah,
they literally sell the shit.
If a person have what's equivalent to $5,000. They have $5,000 in dope, and they get caught with that, they're going to jail forever. Mm-hmm. Think about it.
Mm-hmm. So, how you paid the fine?
I haven't used my real money for anything. I don't know. Right? Yeah. What we were just doing before I came here?
You know what the hell we was doing? We was at the bank.
Oh, exactly. This is all I do. I work at the bank and I work at the mall.
I got a job.
He got two jobs.
I got a lot of jobs. Anything else? Any other questions? No, I've been doing this for a while, man.
So you train scammers?
Hmm? I was about to say.
The training of scammers.
Oh, yeah. I was the first young dude from Patterson that was in the field. I was the first one. They not gonna mention scamming.
But I'm
the first one. And I brought it to the town and let people have fun with it. And now everybody think they're doing it. But I sit back. I'm not going out buying no crazy ass cars or trying to rent mansions or taking trips and video. I'm not doing none of that. I did that shit already. I done had houses in Miami. I got a passport. I went to Ghana. I've been places. Like, I did shit with this shit for years. And I did that shit like my first 2 years of scamming. After that, you know, I started seeing jealousy, envy, and all that shit. I was doing this shit thinking it was all love. But after the situation and that shit happened to me, it was like, let me just dumb it down. Minimize the people that I hang around, minimize my business and what I do. And half of the shit that I really do, I don't post. I go to celebrities' house on the weekend and go pick up $10,000-$20,000 and get paid in advance. Or I done did shit with a lot of And with this shit with me doing this shit, my house is that's where I've been, the low, and you know, the person I am and the character that I have, it allowed me to make a little web series to the part where I got a little deal going on with Nick the Grid. I'm signing a little deal, and you know, got some movie stuff going on. I'm gonna get out of there because I'll be doing stand up comedy, and it's all up for me, all up for me. So I got a power when I say I will never work again.
So, any advice you got to like any up and coming scammers? Because the business ain't gonna stop. It's gonna always be around.
It's gonna always grow. I'm learning that shit. It's gonna always grow. There's gonna be a lot of people doing it. I feel like if you're trying to do it, you don't need no team. But if you're dealing with a lot of money, you might feel comfortable with a team. I feel like watch your back, watch the people that's around you. You have no circle. Be smart. Don't let people know where you live. Have different addresses if you're getting enough money to. And be humble.
And remember, you're a scammer.
and learn how to fuck with a computer. You gotta learn how to fuck with a computer if you want to scam. You gotta learn how to fuck with a computer. You gotta learn how to fuck with the dark web. You gotta invest in Bitcoin. Right now, Bitcoin is going at 40,000 for one Bitcoin. And they mining for Bitcoin. It's hard to explain. Mind is like give or take. They letting people.
So basically,
you know what mining is?
So basically, like it's like a couple of mil. It's only 21 billion Bitcoin. It's only gonna always be 21 billion Bitcoin. Bitcoin was going at such a
low. No, how? If it's mined,
I'm telling you how mining works. So basically, it's like Bitcoin been going for a minute. It's like 2007, right? You feel me?
Yeah.
So
yeah,
it's lost. It's like hundreds of thousands of millions of lost wallets out there of Bitcoin where people can't get if you lose your shit.
Uh-huh.
Like you, because now it's attached to wallets that you really can't lose your shit, because it's like four or five different authentications that you could get to make sure you get your shit back. Yeah. But back then they didn't have all that shit, and it really wasn't wallets, because it was really for niggas on the dark web and shit. So now if like mining is looking for those, getting into those banks and splitting them up.
That's what it is. But yeah, that's a good investment, all that shit. So get that. Don't be scared of the dark web. Get you a printer. Get you a laptop. Get you a bosser, a reader and writer. Y'all need to be taking notes right now.
Real shit. Get your notebooks.
Really, y'all and listen. Pens. Get a laptop. Get an embosser. Get a reader and writer. You're going to get a chip machine. There you go. Make sure you hit any dollar store and steal a card. And you're good.
What?
You only got to pay for them when you put money on it.
No, you don't pay for them.
That's what I'm saying.
You put money on them, it's like, fuck.
I'm saying, at the register.
Like a gift card.
They worthless until you put money on them at the register.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I don't need no money on them. I do this out.
Oh, all
right, so I want to get into my rent and then we up out here. So I've been looking at a lot of shit, and it's this documentary called Heaven's Gate, The Cult of All Cults. All right, so I've been on my cult shit for a little minute, because like What happened that week? Oh, they like to call that shit a suicide. They killed them people. America killed them people. So now I'm looking at like what really happened in cults and shit. You know? And I settled on this. That's besides the point. It's a good documentary. Check it out, HBO Max. But America isn't okay with cults until they can tax them bitches. Once you stop being able to tax them bitches, cause look at what Instagram is, what fucking Facebook is. It's a bunch of little cults. Oh, I like B. Simone. Oh, I like fucking Justin Harris. Oh, I like Country Wayne. You're just fucking culting for these motherfuckers. Like, Logan versus whatever his brother fucking name is. Like, it's a fucking thing. It's a whole thing. And they teaching our kids fucking young. Like, America is okay with cults if you pay your taxes. That's all I can say. Time I hear about a nigga fucking prick saying he Jesus and shit, leave me the fuck alone and leave him the fuck alone. If they want to kill themselves, let that shit be. this has been a wrap for our show. You can find us at Sativa_Jones on Instagram, Sativa Jones on every other platform.
I thought it was Sativa_Jones.
No, it's Visionary Dodger.
Yeah, you said Visionary underscore show.
He's going to argue. No, I'm kidding. I'm
kidding. Sorry. I should have minded my business.
You was right. That's that weed. Visionary.Jones on Instagram.
And Sativa Jones on all platforms. Follow us, the podcast, at the Sativa Experience Pop. But this is Sativa Experience on our Facebook page, where you'll see every show, and on Visionary Shit YouTube channel.
I guess you can follow me at _ Olivia Wild. That's OLIVIAWILD. That's on Instagram. You can follow me at Olivia Wild on TikTok. You can follow me at Olivia Wild on Clubhouse. And you could don't follow me on Facebook.
Oh, before we leave Tip and Tiny alone.
Yeah.
Wow, what's wrong with them? Oh yeah, they having a little fucking cold, right?
Yeah. I can't even speak. You gotta wait. If you can wait, if you can wait, you can win. You gotta wait. That's the goal. You gotta wait. If you can wait, you can win.
It's like a radio station.
That's what it is, and it's not like they make it boring. It's a radio station.
It's patient. Yeah. Right. Question might get answered while you online, so you can make up a whole new one.
Shout out to the Industry Connect.
I'm about to get into fan only, so if my fan
only.
Only fans.
Oh yeah, only fans. What is it?
Only now fans. You said it right. Pay us, bitch. Only.
Fan only.
My name's gonna be Love me long time, long dingling.
That's a
long name, yeah.
Easy to find, you get it, you know what I'm going with. Oh, that's long dingling.
LALD. And the difference between the dream and the visionary, and the visionary and the dream is the dream has his eyes closed, and the visionary has his eyes open. Blah!